Ready?
Alright.
Do a song. We have to do it. I'm preached up.
Doors and on the windows, and I mean, you just didn't feel safe. And then I remember when he escalated and went from just at first, it was like, well, he goes in where men aren't there. And I had my husband, and then next thing I know, he's got he's going into homes with the husband home and tying them up and doing all that. And I thought, oh my word, you're not even safe with your husband in the house. And I don't, up to that date, I had never been petrified over something I'd heard on the news, or you know, you think, oh, it's not going to happen to me, but for some reason he affected everybody. But you didn't feel safe. You felt like, yeah, he could come to my house and he could do this to me. And it was terrifying, absolutely terrifying. And I have thought about him all these years. I honestly haven't thought, how was he not caught? I don't understand, how could this happen? And then recently they did a couple of the documentaries, and I have just been so into it, you have no idea. My husband goes, will you watch that? I said, Mark, it's just uncanny to me how he stopped, and they've never been able to catch him. And for this to happen today, I'm shaking. I've shook ever since I found out this morning. To know that it was so close. I mean, yeah. So close. And I remember the detective on that, Paul Holes, I think that was his name. Such a great guy. And he said, I think he still lives in the Sacramento area. And he was right. Gosh. And my little daughter-in-law grew up right here. And she says that neighbors used to say he was the creepy Joe because he would yell at the kids. And she used to jog by his house. And a little did I know that one of my family members were that close to that monster.
Yeah, Rose in there. A couple hours later, I was sitting in my house. The day was winding down and coming to an end. So I turned on my TV and cooked it over to the news. And what I saw, I almost could not comprehend. There was a preacher man in cuffs, he'd taken money from his church and stuck his bank account with priceless dollar bills. But even still, I can't say much, cause you know.